Welcome to the Purpose Chasers Podcast. I'm your host, Mark Crandall. In 2015, I dreaded most of my day-to-day life. I was working unfulfilling jobs, wasting time playing video games, binging on TV, just to get my mind off the fact that I had a calling to do more and to be more. For years, I wanted to write a book, to become a paid speaker, and to empower others to achieve their dreams. In 2016, I took a stand. I invite you now to do the same. As Purpose Chasers, we refuse to settle for average. We chase our dreams, we accomplish our goals, and we support, encourage, and challenge our community to create the lives we want to live. Why have we Purpose Chasers taken this stand? Because life is too short to not live fulfilled. Enjoy this episode and take action. I wanted to drop a bonus episode, if you will, in regards to what's going on with the world with the coronavirus. And I am no expert, so I will not be talking about the specifics of the coronavirus or COVID-19 in the sense of providing any medical advice or anything of that nature. What I wanted to jump on and talk about today is there are really two ways to view everything that's going on in the world right now. And a majority of the world is viewing this situation from a very, very scared, scarcity-minded standpoint. And that is what I'm really, myself, trying to avoid. And I'm not immune to feeding chaos and fear and watching the news nonstop. And this topic that I wanted to jump on and just kind of highlight today and you know, provide some of my insights for as like a bonus episode on the Purpose Chasers was brought to me yesterday morning. I've had a few individuals that are in my inner circle that are like my peers that I bounce stuff off, reach out to me over the last week. And one really struck me yesterday. It was a really good friend of mine. I'm not going to name drop. I will keep you guessing though. He has been on the show and he called me yesterday and we were talking and just kind of, I was, you know, sharing with him like the shifts that I'm making and asking what he's doing in his business and how everything's going. And he paused me in the call and he's like, man, I called you for a pep talk. I'm actually really effed up. My mind is, I'm having a lot of negative, like limiting beliefs and negative thoughts. And I'm not really seeing a way out right now. And I paused him and I said, okay, so let me ask you this question. Have you asked yourself what opportunities you're not currently seeing? And he paused and he's like, no, that's a really, really good question. And I was like, my experience with this COVID-19 and everything that's going on in the world right now is that everyone is so focused on the negative and dismantling and projecting, right? So that's what happens when fear is instilled in humans. Our fear is not even a reality. Our fear is based off of assumptions that we make created by stories from our past. I know, that's a real head full right there. But our feelings are created by assumptions and predictions we make about what's going to happen in the future, founded off stories that we have created about ourselves based on our past. Again, it's a head full, I know, but I'm going to try to explain to you a little bit. So I asked him, you know, what was going on in his business, what shifts he was making, what was going on with his family. He started to identify the pluses. He's like, you know, I'm getting to spend more time with my children and, you know, I'm at home more and I'm getting some projects done. And then he immediately went to, but the business this and the business that. And I asked him and I said, I'm not going to drop his name. And I said, he may be open to me sharing it. I haven't asked though, so I won't. I asked this man and I said, what from your past is making you believe that you are not capable to carry your vision beyond what's going on? Here's the truth, guys. And gals, I'm going to hit you with it square in the mouth. So if you don't want to hear some hard truth right now in the midst of some chaos and fear and confusion and all that's going on in the world, feel free to hit pause or don't listen. But if you do want to potentially get shaken out of whatever mindset you're in right now, then keep listening. And I said to him, are you going to chase your dreams or are you going to fold up? Everything that happens in the world is nothing more than a test. And it's testing your resolve to be one of the purpose chasers. Are you going to use the opportunity to find new ways to claw at your dream? So COVID-19 is an opportunity for Americans and for the world to find deeper levels of strength. Now, don't get me wrong. It is completely misfortunate. Like it is, don't get me wrong at all. I was on the phone with Carolyn, who's been a guest on the show. She was talking to me about the inner workings of the hospital this morning. She was actually walking into the hospital as I was FaceTiming with her. She's like, Mark, it's chaos. It is. She goes, it's terrifying. But she has one of the strongest mindsets I know. And she's looking for the opportunity, right? When we focus on the negative and we focus on this, that, and the other, we completely lose sight of why we're doing what we're doing. And you hear me preach it all the time. If you don't know your why, you're not going to fulfill on what it is you want to create in life. And so I asked this man on the call, what is your why? And he told me. And I said, are you going to fold up? And he said, no. So I said, now I'm going to ask you the question that I asked you in the beginning of this call one more time. What opportunities are you not currently able to see? And this man goes, well, every other business in my industry in the state has closed down. I'm going to call all these businesses and I'm going to ask them if they have work to refer, and I'll give them a referral fee if they refer it to us. And his brain just started firing. I haven't heard back from him, which means he's in a different mindset. When you focus on the negative and you focus on the fact that we're quarantined right now, we are in our homes, and the world is falling apart around us, and we're watching CNN, and we're being told what to believe. And I won't get into that whole side of my mind, but we're, you know, and you're just feeding the negative. My wife and I have a rule right now: no news in the home. We're not consuming any news right now. Why? Because I can't. I can't consume the news. I can't get consumed by the negativity and what's going on in the scared minds. I need to stay strong. I need to keep my mindset dialed in because I'm not folding up. I'm not. And you're going to see all kinds of people jump online and launch online businesses. And all of a sudden, they're going to be life coaches. Watch how quick they're gone because they don't know their why. So I wanted to share this with you. What are you focused on right now? And what opportunities are you not currently seeing? There are opportunities right now in your life. Maybe it's an opportunity to get quiet and reset. Maybe it's an opportunity to read a book. Maybe it's an opportunity to start your book. Maybe it's an opportunity to do home projects, which I started last weekend. You know, I started renovating the basement, which was something I was going to hire for, but I'm capable of doing the work. But this, you know, isolation or home quarantine, if you will, not that we believe that we've come into contact with it, but maybe I believe everyone possibly has, right? We don't know. Provided me some extra time from not running all over the place so that, you know, I had two speaking gigs that were canceled because of this. And it afforded me the time to do some home projects. Plus I started the Purpose Chasers book. Plus Justin and I launched the mastermind. So what opportunities are you not currently seeing in your life right now? And what action can you take? So I want to ask you again, are you one of the purpose chasers? Or are you going to fold up? Because purpose chasers don't fold up. We support, encourage, and challenge each other, and we find a way. If you are not a part of the Purpose Chasers community on Facebook, go to @thepurposechasers and join the group. I have been very active in there. I've been doing 2-3 lives a week. The community is super supporting each other. Everyone is trying to keep everyone focused on what opportunities they are not seeing. It's a blessing that we get to dive deep in a time like this. So go inside. And it is in these moments that we find out what we are made of. A lot of people are going to fold up. I'm not one of them. And I happen to have been called to empower individuals like yourself to not fold up either. So take a moment, ask yourself why you're doing it, and then ask yourself this question. What opportunities am I not seeing? And then look. So many people are not going to take a moment. I don't even know what the percentage is. 99.9% of people are not asking themselves right now, what opportunities am I not seeing? Is it an opportunity to serve? Is it an opportunity to carry a valuable message to individuals that truly need to hear it right now? What are you not seeing? Purpose Chasers, I love you. I'm so grateful for you. The community inside the Purpose Chasers community has fed the fire inside of me through this darkness. The community is supporting each other. We are going to make it on the other side of this. If you're not a part of the community, I encourage you to join. If you are, I would really love to hear from you. What opportunities are you not seeing? And let's go take advantage of the opportunities while we have the time. I will talk to you soon. I want to thank you for being a part of the Purpose Chasers community and invite you to seek the support that allowed me to take my stand towards creating the life of my dreams. Join our exclusive members-only Facebook group at The Purpose Chasers. Also, follow us on all social media platforms at The Purpose Chasers. Until we connect again, remember to live your life like it's the only one you have, because your dreams should never be on hold.